you know, 10-3 in the non-conference. I think, you know, you get to the end of non-conference, it's a chance to kind of step back and go, okay, you're 10-3. And I told the team in there, 10-3 is something to be proud of. And we should be proud of what we've accomplished to this point. You know, we worked really hard to have the right to go out and have a good non-conference record. And we want to now go out. We started the conference play here in a week. We're going to have to work really, really hard to earn the right to feel that way when conference play ends. So we can't take any steps backwards in our investment, in our approach, in our work ethic. I think it's got to really increase. And then I hope when we finish conference play, we can sit here and say, hey, we're whatever and whatever, and we're proud of it. We worked really hard to do it. But 10-3 is something I'm proud of. Anybody that knows me knows, you know, I'd love to be better, and I'd love the record to be better, but I do think sometimes you got to recognize the sacrifices and the work that young people have made, that they're doing some nice things. So happy to get a win and get these guys home for Christmas. They probably need a break from me. I'm a real pain in the ass because I expect a certain type of approach and mentality every day. And the honest truth is the guys have been really trying. They're really trying to give it to us and do it right, and trying to do the things that we ask. And it's probably never enough for me, and it'll never be enough because I'm always going to want more. And so they probably need a 3 or 4 day break from me and spend time with families and enjoy Christmas, and that'll probably be healthy mentally for everybody. If I had my way, and I am excited to see my family back in North Carolina, but if I had it my way, I'd probably wish we were practicing tomorrow, and I would sacrifice Christmas to be able to get better, but I do think it's good for our team that they'll be able to get home. Oh, last thing before you guys ask questions. I only had a chance to meet Mamadou a handful of times when I got the job here, and just thought he was a terrific young man. And I wish he wouldn't have played so well for our defense tonight. But, you know, for somebody who invested in this program and spent a lot of time here and was really well-liked by everybody that he touched, that's one thing that's been so obvious, which speaks to his character. For him to come in here and have a really good night and shoot the ball well, I'm really happy for him.
Is this team about where you want them to be? I mean, obviously there's things you want better. There's maybe things that are overperforming where you thought you would be. But is this team on track for where you saw through 13 games?
Yeah. Chad, I honestly don't do a lot of projections and stuff like that. You know, certainly that's human nature to a certain extent. But I don't do, like, the projection thing in my mind with any team I've coached. And this sounds like coach talk, and it's really not. I mean, it's really just about today. And what do we have to do to take a step forward and get better today? And then it's about that tomorrow and the next day. And I think every time that I've had a group that's really embraced that and had enough natural gifts, we found great success. But I think this year, more than any other, you know, knowing where we would be and where we are, I honestly had no idea going into it. You know, I knew we had a good group of players. I knew we had some talented kids. But when you're putting it together so late, everybody's new to each other. The last thing I try to do is project where we'd be at Christmas. And again, this group, for the most part, has been really good about coming in every day trying to get better. And sometimes you do that and you look up and you go, okay, we're doing some nice things.
We asked the guys about this too, but the zone offense flow execution looked better, especially compared to, you know, you talked after the Xavier game about struggling with it. What emphasis have you put on that the past couple weeks?
Does it look like we've been practicing zone offense?
It does.
Well, that makes me feel good because we have. You know, I know we just, you know, it's been something we've seen here over the last 2-3 weeks is people changing defenses on us. And then, you know, anytime somebody does something that has success, you're going to see it more. We saw it again tonight. And we've been working on dealing with changing defenses and still being aggressive and attacking and flowing. And then we put in some stuff against the zone. We made some adjustments to kind of our flow in the zone. And I think it's been significantly better here over the last 2 games. I thought the only time tonight we were a little stagnant, you know, they jumped into a 2-2-1, and we just didn't. We didn't attack it. And so when you don't attack it, now you don't, you know, start attacking the zone they drop into. And then, okay, so we're not attacking it. We barely get it over. We look discombobulated. I call a play. And then we have a lineup in that doesn't kind of understand every spot. and now all of a sudden you're in late clock from someone that coached three-quarter court pressure for six straight years. Like, that's what I'm used to doing to other people, so that really pissed me off to be on the other side of it. But we put Mike Saunders in the game, and I thought he really attacked the 2-2-1, and then I thought we got back to having some success in zone offense.
AJ's a guy that, as soon as you take him off the bench, he's aggressive. He's not shy when he's on offense. Was he that way at UNCG? Is that just the kind of guy he is? AJ.
Oh, AJ is, he's not shy at all on a basketball. He's not shy anywhere. I mean, he's got a great personality. He's very self-confident, which I've always really liked about him, even when I recruited him. And he's not shy when he catches the ball, right? He'll let that thing go. He's got some swagger offensively. He's got some really good feel offensively. You see him hitting the back door. We're running the set that we run often to get Dave in a spread ball screen. And we've been saying, hey, look for the back door. Look, we've been saying it from the first day we put it in. The first guy that's even thought about throwing it was AJ. And I kind of questioned the pass, but got through and we laid it in. No, he's not shy at all. He's got real offensive feel and real offensive ability. You know, you look down and, you know, he's 1-for-6 from three, and he can really shoot the ball. He'll do better shooting the basketball. He's a good offensive player. I want him to be a little better defensively. He knows that, and he'll continue to get better defensively. He's been hearing that from me for a year and a half.
Coach, I think the phrase I heard you yelling out most tonight was motion. How did you feel the off-ball movement looked overall, and how did the ball move? Did you feel tonight?
I think our offensive execution is improving. Again, we've spent a lot of time working at it. You know, and this is like one of the, I think any coach will relate to this. We've been spending a lot more time working at offensive execution. You see it improving, and you know, now all of a sudden transient defense looks like it stinks, right? So, you know, that's just how you only have so much time on the court, and the things that you work on are the things that generally will carry over. So, no, I thought our ball movement was really good. I thought, especially in the first half, I thought we shared it really well. Like, David and Julius didn't have a great scoring night, but I thought he broke the defense down and got us great looks or put the defense in rotation. And I think that led, you know, like, we had a good night offensive rebounding, tip-ins, tip-outs, you know, even a couple we should have snagged and we didn't. But you have a better chance to get to the offensive board when the defense is in rotation and you take a great shot. And we took a lot of quality shots tonight, putting the defense in rotation, and that was a lot of it with execution and ball movement and guys like David making some really good plays for others.
Kind of piggybacking off that, kind of answered my question a little bit, but with David not shooting as well as he did tonight, how big was it for you guys to have Micah and Mikey kind of step in and as your lead ball handlers kind of run the offense the way they did to get some easy baskets?
Yeah, like I'm really happy for Micah because, he's worked really hard. He can really shoot the ball. He's a really good offensive player. And you kind of look down at the stat sheet after every game, and he's struggled to shoot it thus far in the year in games. He hasn't struggled in practice, but he's struggled in games. And you kind of just keep telling him, keep going, keep shooting. Don't overthink it. It'll happen. And you look down tonight, and he had a really good shooting night and relative to what he's been doing. So I'm pleased. And then you look down, he's 4-0, and he's been great. It's just a turnover all year, you know, just taking care of the ball and making simple plays. So, no, I'm pleased with his effort. And, you know, Mike Saunders was fantastic and, you know, used the speed and aggressiveness to really break the game open for us.
Defensive rebounding has been not great through the non-conference, but the last two games you guys seem to be doing quite a bit better. Is that another one of those you've been working on hard on it and they're getting there?
Yes, we've been working hard. We've been emphasizing it. And, you know, it's not all coaching, guys. I mean, they are starting to understand how important it is for our team to have success. So they are really doing a better job of five guys pursuing every ball. I mean, we're not a team where two or three guys on the perimeter can leak out and we're just going to clean the glass with some, you know, elite rebounder. We're a team that needs to do it collectively. And I'm seeing guys making a better effort, especially from the perimeter, to come in and help us. Because a lot of the times, I mean, you guys are watching it like I am, there's a lot of rebounds that happen on our defensive possessions that aren't clean, where the ball's tipped around or it's loose. And we have to get all those, and that's going to take a collective effort. We're working on it. The guys are trying. And I saw a better effort here the last two games.
Anything else?
Yeah, one more. We heard Hayden use the phrase dropping pennies in. You've used that too. We've seen you do that at practice. What does that mean?
means that we reached our standard for how we're supposed to work and how we're supposed to approach getting better every day. And if we reach that standard, every player on the team, we all agree to it as a group at center court, then everybody participated in practice, drops a little penny in a jar. And the idea is just focus on one day at a time and keep dropping them in, and that thing will build up over time and you'll find some good results. So it sounds a little, quirky probably, but it's something that we really believe in.
Is that a Carolina thing, something you've done in the past?
I'm so unoriginal. I'm not sure where I stole that one. I can't remember. We've been doing it for years. Probably it's probably the seventh year I've done that. I have all the jars from every team up in my office, which I like to look back and see how some teams got better than others. And generally, those teams had better years than others. But I'll be honest, Justin, I couldn't tell you where I stole it from. I highly doubt it was my idea. I'm not that good.
Who's in charge of getting pennies?
I have no idea. I hope not a GA that probably can't afford it. I should probably pay somebody back for all that.
I don't want to end it on a low note, but we asked Luke the same question this morning about kids going back to their families and just the health concerns and COVID. Will there be a message from you to say, hey, guys, just make sure we're being smart and staying healthy out here?
You asked Coach Pickle that question this morning?
One of them, of many.
Yeah, whatever he said would be my answer. I want to do what he does. I mean, that's somebody I want to learn from. So whatever he said, I agree with it. Now, I'm sure it's a similar message. Listen, we had a talk with the guys. That's the last thing I said in the locker room. We can't control COVID. I try really hard. I fail miserably at times, but I try really hard to control the things that I can control and to kind of let the things I can't control not get at me. I fail, but I think that's one of the goals in coaching and playing is to try to – we can't control COVID. We can control how we handle it. And we got to be really, really diligent and disciplined in the decisions we make as a group with everything that's going on in the country. So am I worried about guys going home and getting around friends and family and getting COVID? Absolutely. But I don't think it's worth not letting them go home. Just mentally, emotionally, it's healthy to get around your family, and I really believe in that. But I hope we'll make the right decisions, and we talked about what those are in the locker room.
All right, thanks, guys.